Gamescom, boys. Bungie is at it, and they showed us a lot of good juicy stuff. There's no way around it. This stuff looks nasty. Essentially, the event opened up with showing us a lot of the finisher moves, which we've already seen. We'll actually get 3 different finisher moves for our subclasses given to us when Shadowkeep launches. So I'm assuming we're all gonna have like a default finisher. And from what was said about finishers is, number one, you are not immune in your finisher. You can actually get killed while doing a finishing move. Number two, finishers can actually be done back to back. There is no cooldown. The moment you see an enemy glow, you can immediately finish them. Wow, that came out wrong. But you get the point, boys. You can continuously keep finishing your enemies over and over. Now, the first thing we got to see, though, was the artifacts at work, something that's been eluding us up until this point. This one right here is the Gate Lord's Eye. It states the charged eye of a Vex Gate Lord can be used to infiltrate the most protected layers of their network and reverse engineer to confer incredible powers to its bearer. Now notice right under it, it says that it lasts until the end of Season of Undying. I'm pretty sure that's just like the loot bonus that you get from your artifact that Luke Smith was talking about last week. That does not mean that the artifact and what it gives you in terms of mods will become useless after Season of the Undying. No, it should remain useful, but again, remember it resets season to season for like solo players that don't want to participate in those pinnacle activities. Now let's continue. The second screenshot we have here is the Gate Lord Eye itself. And the first mod we got to see is Thundercoil. Now first up, it states that it is a class item mod. So obviously this mod, which will cost 6 energy, can only be applied to our class item. But it grants bonus damage for all of our arc melee abilities, and it refunds super energy on finisher final blows. Now something to take away from that is obviously finisher final blows uses up some level of our super energy, which is kind of a bummer, but the way it's supposed to work is the benefits from those finishers, especially when combined with these perks, far outweighs what it costs. But just taking something like Thundercoil by itself, you can imagine how well this class item mod would pair with something like Liar's Handshake and 1-2 Punch. It may even grant you enough bonus damage to allow something like Bottom Tree Striker with Knockout to do one-hit KOs inside of Crucible. So much potential here. Now the next screenshot is called Arc Battery. This is another class item mod. It costs 5 energy and it grants overshield and reduced cooldowns during activation for all arc class abilities. Fellas, this is insane. I go around a corner, I'm one shot. I pop a barricade. Now I just granted myself an overshield. On top of that, a reduction in my cooldowns. If you're a hunter and you start taking too much damage, roll on the ground. Boom, overshield. Now, depending on how much overshield it grants us, I don't know, but it's definitely something that can keep you alive. That is a huge one right there though, and we're just barely touching the surface. Next one is Oppressive Darkness. Now this is another class item mod, and I'm starting to think that everything in this column are class item mods, but it costs 6 energy and it states that causing damage with a void grenade adds a weakened effect to enemies. Okay, immediately I'm thinking of like Shattering Strike on the Hunter class. Proc something like Shattering Strike though. Go in for the melee, apply the debuff, throw a void wall grenade at the same time, and then, I don't know, follow up with a trench barrel shotgun. Now, I don't know what the values are, but the fact that we are now getting ability buffs as well as debuffs from simply class item mods, this changes the game. I feel like every one of these I'm reading, I'm freaking out right now. Now, the next one is Heavy Finisher. This one is another class item mod. Again, this is confirming that maybe this entire column here are class item mods. It costs 7 energy. Finishers generate heavy ammo, but it requires 1/2 of your super. Now, they actually mentioned this. This is one of those pros and cons. You go in for the finisher, you burn up 1/2 of your super, but you generate heavy ammo for actually you and your entire team. Now, it may not be useful for everything, but if we are to get something like a horde mode, not saying that's gonna come or not, this could be extremely useful. Now, before we move on, I wanna go ahead and wrap up things with our Gate Lord's Eye right here and artifacts in general. First up, it seems to unlock from left to right. And after you fulfill points down below, it unlocks the next column. Now, how you even get these points to unlock, I have no idea. It shows a 12 out of 12 over on the bottom right, as well as a plus 14. And I'm pretty sure the plus 14 is just the light advantage that this artifact grants us. Getting these points, though, seems to be maxed out to where you can only achieve a certain amount of mods. Now, there is a reset artifact, and I do not know what the cons are to resetting your artifact. Do you lose your points? Do you have to regain another 12 points? I'm not sure. But I do want to go ahead and look at these other mods that we have here before we move into the moon map. Anti-barrier rounds. This one states this mod is usable only on auto rifles and submachine guns. So it is a weapon mod. And it states shield piercing rounds designed to bypass combined defenses strong against barrier champions. So what I'm getting from this one is like a souped up armor piercing rounds. But what's so amazing about this is that's normally a magazine perk that would need to roll on the weapon. And of course, most people would rather use like some sort of magazine benefiting perk or reload perk, or in some like PvP ricochet rounds. A lot of people don't use armor piercing rounds, right? This mod is incredible because you're able to take what was essentially a perk, but now apply it as a weapon mod, which again, changes the game up even more. The next screenshot we have is the same thing. It's an anti-barrier hand cannon. This is a hand cannon mod and grants us the same thing. Shield piercing rounds designed to bypass combined defenses, strong against barrier champions. Now, we haven't really talked about what barrier champions are. We really don't know what they are. Probably has something to do with like moon level activities. But regardless, this is incredible. These are major, major changes coming. And it seems to be another way for us to obtain weapon mods as well as armor mods through our artifact system. Now, one other thing that I saw, and it was right before the screenshot cut out, because they were going back and forth between Bungie devs and Deej and the nice ladies on stage. But if you can see it, it's overload rounds. This is another weapon mod. It states that it's usable on auto rifles and submachine guns. And the description states uninterrupted fire grants bullets that cause disruptive delaying ability energy regeneration and lowering combat damage output, strong against overload champions. I'm very interested to know how that works in something like PvP. If I shoot a hunter, will it delay their ability energy regeneration? Also, will it lower their damage output? These are some crazy mods, guys, and like we're only getting a glimpse of it. My lord, I wish I was at Gamescom. Now, back to how we apply these mods. If you see right here, we have the Hunter Cloak and the class item mod here that was granted from our artifact, which of course has like a different color than everything else. This is where you slap the mod on. And this is the one that actually grants you and your fire team heavy ammo, but it does require one half of your super. And this is when you, of course, do finisher moves on an enemy. And of course, the next one is Thunder Coil itself, which is the one that grants you bonus damage for all your arc melee abilities and refund super energy on finisher final blows. Now again, this is more of a passive one. You don't use up any super energy on finisher blows, so of course that's an active one, but the bonus damage one is really big as that's more of a passive buff for all of your arc melee abilities. Now the next screenshot is actually of the moon itself. On the top half here, we see Sorrow's Harbor, Hellmouth, which I know many of us remember, Archer's Line, Anchor of Light, but a full picture of it, we actually get to see what appears to be three strikes. Now there's a Vex icon all the way to the left, which seems to be the same level of color as what we saw on our artifact, which makes me think that whatever we do there may actually grant us points to possibly unlock more mods through our artifact. I don't know. Now I'm not gonna deep dive into the map. I know there was some leaks posted on Reddit and I think 4chan as well in regards to like the narrative behind the moon. We'll get into that in another video. We're just purely taking screenshots and what we saw today at Gamescom. Now next up is the exotic assassin's cow. Oh yeah, we finally got to see a screenshot of this. A lot of us were wondering if this was just a cosmetic item in Eververse. No boys, it is an exotic for the hunter class. It comes with the exotic perk Vanishing Execution. Defeating a guardian with a melee attack or combating with the finisher grants invisibility and restores a portion of health and shields. This exotic actually sounds very similar to like Don't Touch Me's back in Destiny 1. The difference was Don't Touch Me granted you invisibility when you received melee damage, whereas Assassin's Cowl here grants you invisibility on top of health restoration when you melee attack an enemy or of course do a finisher blow. I think in this current sandbox, I would be like, ah, that's pretty good. Not a bad exotic. I don't know if I would say it would be like a tier one exotic though. With the new mods though, granted we haven't even seen like specific ones, like maybe even subclass specific ones, this can be a hell of an exotic. Actually, to be honest with you, there's so many exotics right now that I'm like just thinking of that can be disgusting just because of our new mod system coming. All right, now let's take a look at the strike that we saw. This was actually a strike that they were actually launching, but they didn't actually show gameplay of it. This is probably Bungie's way of just purely showing us what to expect from this new strike layout. But this one is Nightmare Hunt, Servitude. It says, defeat the Nightmare of Zydron. I hope I'm saying that right, which is a gate lord. Now, something I want to take away from this is the weekly challenge down here says that there is a powerful gear item of tier 1 as the reward. Now, I don't know if there's going to be like multiple tiers in powerful gear, depending on the challenge or the activity, but that's something that's very interesting. Now, on the strike itself, we actually get to see difficulties that you can choose. You've got Adept, which actually gave you the mission modifier air superiority with an 860 recommended power. The next one is Hero, which gives us 4 mission modifiers, air superiority, champion's overload, champion bearer, and torment of Zydron. Now, the champion barrier and overload, again, this is when something like the mods we just looked at, which of course will allow our bullets to bypass these barriers, become extremely important. And again, for that champion overload portion, having that weapon mod, which gives us overload rounds, will now become extremely valuable as it's strong specifically against overload champions. Now, the third and final difficulty is Legend. Now, this one comes with 6 mission modifiers. Essentially, everything in this except you now have equipment locked and now you have match game. So again, this amps up the difficulty even more with a recommended power of 950. Very cool stuff here, guys. Essentially, these missions going forward are going to give a lot of value to the weapon mods as well as the armor and class item mods coming in Armor 2.0. Now, the last thing we saw was the hand cannon Loud Lullaby. This is like Eris Morn and her hand cannon. You could see like the chain or the whatever it is on it. Bracelet, I don't even know. Feathers as well. It's a 110 round per minute hand cannon though. And this one, I would say is a decent roll for PvE. 4 times the charm, field prep, what's that, tactical mag? I don't know. Nothing really crazy about this one. I'm sure this is just them showing one of the main theme weapons coming this October. But if you notice there at the empty mod socket, they didn't really go in there to show what each one of these are. But the mods themselves don't cost anything, at least from the artifacts. And this looks like the ones that give you the barrier damage, as well as what looks to appear to be the overload rounds for hand cannons. So guys, that's pretty much everything from Gamescom that I saw today that just like jumped out at me. There is some leaks, so our next video will be on those leaks. It is from 4chan. So, I mean, I don't know. Not saying not to believe it, but it's kind of like up in the air, you know? Either way it goes, the mod system that's coming this October, to me, changes the game up more than when it was when we went from year 1 to year 2 in Forsaken. This is huge, guys. The amount of builds that can come from this, builds in way more depth than what we've seen previously, is crazy. It really makes me wonder how the hell Bungie is going to balance all of this. But hey, I'm completely fine with this next season being absolutely chaotic. Well, fellas and ladies, thank you all for coming and watching. And as always,
slap that like button like your mama told you right.